Hi students, you all are very warmly welcome for this online session. Now we are starting the lesson number 5. Okay, the name of the lesson is Arache. Okay, Arache, it's the name of girl from southern Europe. This is the story from the southern Europe. Now I will read warm up for you. Arache, a lovely maiden in Greek mythology, was gifted with the power of weaving the most beautiful designs, but her pride in her talent led to her downfall. See, Arache, she was the lovely maiden. Maiden means she was the unmarried Greek. She was from the Greek. And she was gifted with the power of weaving the most beautiful design. She was having knowledge of weaving different kinds of designs, but because of her pride, she was downfall. Because of her pride, her all the dignity has been came down. Now I will read for you. Let's read. While reading, I will explain it also. There lived a Greece in ancient times, a young maiden whose name was Arache. Now see, they have given who is Arache. She was the Greece girl from the southern Europe, and she was maiden, means she was single, unmarried, and her name was Arache. She lived with her parents and brothers and sisters at foot of Mount Olympus in Thessaly. She was living with family. In her family, there were brothers and sisters, and she used to live foot of Mount Olympus. Okay, at the bottom of the Mount Olympus, she used to live. Their cottage was on the outskirts of village and was surrounded by meadows through which ran a murmuring stream. Where was her home? Cottage means home. It was on the outskirt of the village. Outskirt village means at the boundary of the village, at the and we can say at the boundary of the village. And it was surrounded by meadows. Some meadows were there, as well as one murmuring stream was there. Okay, one stream was there. Here in the picture you can see stream. Okay, when the sun shone bright, Arache would walk along the bank of stream. Okay, when the sun shone, when the sun came out bright, she used to walk along the banks of the stream. See, here you can see in the picture, she is walking along with the stream. Okay, let's go on the next page. Before I will read that what we have learned today. There lived in a Greece in ancient times a young maiden whose name was Arache. She lived with her parents and brothers and sister at the foot of Mount Olympus in Thessaly. Their cottage was on the outskirts of a village and was surrounded by meadows, through which ran a murmuring stream. When the sun shone bright, Arache would walk along the banks of the stream. Now let's go on the next page, page number 40. Arache, who was the youngest, was different from her other siblings. This Arache, she was the youngest, she was the smallest, and she was the different from her brothers and sister. She was dreamy and quiet. Now they are talking about her behavior. She was dreamy and quiet. When she wandered away into the field, she would watch the dragonflies and flying in the sun. See, when she used to come out of the home, she used to wander in the fields and she used to watch dragonflies. You know what is dragon? Dragonfly is the insect which were flying in the sun. When the light fell on them, their wings flashed with all the colors of rainbow, and Arache would clap her hands in joy. See, when she used to come out of her home for wandering nearby stream, she used to observe the dragonflies which were flying in the air, and when the light of the sun fell on them, their wings used to shine, it used to flash with all the colors of rainbow. When sun shine and the light of the sun come on their wings, dragonfly's wings, it used to give a different reflection with the rainbow color. Okay, and when the Arache viewed used to see this, she used to clap her hand with joy. Here the spell mistake, you have to correct it. She was charmed with the delicate foliage of the trees and with the pine tree that stood up steeply against the blue sky, and she would sit and gaze for hours at the stately daffodils that grew in the garden grass during early spring, and at the blue recess that fringed the river's brink. Now here we'll understand this line. When Arache used to clap her hand with the joy because she used to see the dragonflies, and she was charmed with the delicate foliage. When she used to see the delicate foliage means the leaves of the tree, see, of the trees, and with the pine trees, see, they have given which leaves of the trees were there? Pine trees that stood up steeply, and these trees, they were stand steeply against the blue sky. Yes, when we are looking the trees, of course these trees are under the blue sky, and she would sit and gaze for hours at the stately daffodils that grew in the green grass during early spring, and even she used to observe the daffodils which were grow in the green grass during early spring, early in the morning, and at the blue recess that fringed her river's brink, and with the blue eyes she used see the river's brink. Okay, the time came when Arache was old enough to begin work, and now she was getting elder because her all the brothers and sisters were elder than her. She was the youngest. Now she was getting old enough to work. First, she was given yellow flax to spin. And see, here in the picture you can see one of the yellow flax was given to her for spinning. She was not interested in her task and was always glad to escape into the field. And she was not interested, for the work was given to her for do. She always liked to wander in the field. Next, Arache was taught to work on loom and to weave. Afterwards, she was getting elder, then it was taught, the work was taught to her on a loom machine, okay, on the machine for weaving. Weaving work was taught to her, and to make bright patterns in her cloth, and it was taught to her how to weave and how to make different patterns on the cloth. At once, she began to love her work and would sit at it as long as daylight lasted. And once she started to love her work, she liked to डू हर वर्क ओके देन वंस शी लाइक टू डू द वर्क शी यूज टू सीट एट लास्ट नाइट शी यूज टू वर्क फॉर मोर अवर्स ऑन दिस वेविंग इन अ शॉर्ट टाइम शी हैड सरपास्ड ऑल हर सिस्टर्स फॉर दे ओ रेगुलर पैटर्न्स बट शी ओ इन टू हर क्लोथ्स द कलर She had seen in the meadows and picture of birds and insects and of trees and flowers. See, the weaving work was taught to her, but she has learned this weaving much better than her siblings, her brothers and sister. See, they have given surpassed all her sisters for they wore regular patterns. And the regular patterns were taught to them only the sisters used to use those patterns but she used to wandered around of the home then she understood different kinds of pattern which she has seen in the nature so these all the pictures all the colors all the patterns she started to owe so her weaving was different than her Sisters. Her fame spread through all the land of Thessaly and strangers came from near and far to admire her work. And when she used to started to use her own ideas, she started to think of her own, she started to use the natural color which the natural pattern which she has seen there so her weaving was different and people was liking her weaving so strangers the different people from different area they used to came from near and far to admire her work never before had anyone seen such a wonderful skill the people those they have never seen the skill the wonderful skill like her but alas Arache became proud and when the things had happened to her that her work was praised she was cleverer than her sister she was making different and beautiful weaving so she became proudy She knew that no one could equal her in weaving and when a visitor praise did not please her she would become angry now the she became pride and she think that no one can weave like her when the visitors praises but did not please her she used to get angry Soon her pride grew so great that she began to think that even the gods had never seen anything so fine as her work and her prideness has become high you know she became more pridey than she used to think like that the work I do no one can do like that and if one god also cannot weave Even God also cannot have think like the work which I am doing. So she became very much proudy, and this proud prideness of her it became her down. It will be. We will continue it in the next remaining part of this lesson on the page number 41. Okay by the time we have finished this lesson up to here you have to read this lesson if you read it clearly with the correct pronunciation and the correct words you will understand it very well and you will understand the concept of the lesson see here in this picture you can see her siblings are there and she is waving Up to here you have to read the lesson. Some are the hard words also are given. These all the hard words you have to read and learn. Thank you.